So, I got the gun back from Ruger, and I went to go fire about 40 shots, maybe 50. And I take that back, 60. I was running three different types of ammo and having the exact same problems as I was before. So, I just wanted to show you guys how dirty this thing is now, and I'm gonna post some pictures of how this thing looked exactly as it came back from Ruger. I noticed a strong copper type tone that wasn't present on my previous one, so I'm not sure what's up with that. Maybe an update or something. So anyways, I'm gonna take this apart and I'm gonna show you how dirty this thing is. It's crazy dirty how this gun gets. Okay, we are back with the bolt taken apart and something. So anyways, I'm gonna take this apart and I'm gonna show you how dirty this thing is. It's crazy dirty how this gun gets. Okay, we are back with the bolt taken apart and man, oh man, if this thing was gunky, but look at this. Get the focus in. Does that look like copper fouling to you? Believe me, guys, this thing was fired not more than 1 week ago, tops. I mean, I guarantee you it's been less than 7 days. And all of a sudden I got that kind of corrosion. So I'm gonna see how that is to clean off, because I don't recall having to deal with that much. I always had a bunch of gunk right up around here, like an excessive amount of debris caked on there or cooked on there. But this is different. Let's just say that. Maybe it's all the copper that is built onto this bolt. Maybe that's it. So anyways, I'm having a hard time focusing. I'm gonna go ahead and get back to cleaning this, taking it all apart, and then we'll be back. I did a quick cleaning with some CLP. And I haven't extensively cleaned it. I just wanted to show you. This is a problem I've been having with the last one. Tons and tons of gunk. I mean, this is stuff that you got to take a knife to and literally scrape off. And it takes so much effort and time to do it, to get that thing clean. And it's just caked or cooked on there. What's the actual word I'm looking for? Coked? It's coked on there. The rings also seem a little bit excessive for the size. But in any case, yeah, why does this look all copper on the inside? Why does that look like it's all copper? I don't remember the last bolt looking this way. I really don't. Something's different. So, in other words, hang on here a second. Look how much damn brass is getting stuck in here. I guess first off, we're gonna be running some PMC X-Tack 7.62 by 5.1. Let me adjust this camera here. We are on gas level 3. We're gonna change that right now. Hear some noise, it's my vehicle. I got my dog in there with the AC running right now. And I almost did it, guys. I'll be right back. I didn't put my hearing protection on. I'm gonna put
put my hand around the gas port right here. If I get blasted, I'll know something's going on with that. Still fire. Apparently we got more in here than I thought I did.
So at this point, I started to think that maybe a miracle had happened since the last time I had taken it out after I'd gotten it back from Ruger. But as you'll see, after I get past 10 rounds, it just seems to not work anymore for whatever reason. It starts having hiccups.
Open on the last one. I gotta hurry up here. I got people waiting to use the range today, believe it or not. So I'm gonna load up some Winchester 308 next. All right, Winchester 308, and we are still on level 2 for the gas setting. I just got a dead click. So typically what that's meant is it never loaded an extra round in. We're about to find out. There's no round in there. Did not pick one up. Only a couple shots left, I believe. Did not walk back on the last round. We went and put some more PMC X-TAC back in here. We're on gas setting 2. And I'm gonna try to just go through these pretty quick. Hopefully they all cycle. I have my doubts. No bang. Did not pick up a round. Whoa! We have over here. I didn't hear that one go. Click. Did not feed the next round. quick. It did not open on the last round. That's strange. I don't know what's going on with that. That just happened again. We're gonna throw some different ammo in there. Two rounds. That was two shells. It did not lock back. Did not lock back on its own. I don't know what to think about that. We're gonna try one more bit of ammo. Some hot Winchester 7.62 long range, service grade. And I put it in a different magazine this time, a windowed 25 round magazine, P-Mag. I've been using the magazine which Ruger supplied back with this gun when they returned it to me. Click! Nothing! See what happened? Did not cycle around. Screw this, guys. Look, we're gonna put this on level 3 now for the last rounds, and if anything happens, I'm gonna call it a day. Because I'm beyond frustrated with this weapon. Beyond frustrated. Level 3 has a lot more punch. Feels like too much. I want this to fire on level 2 if it can, but it just won't. And obviously, I gotta run it on max gas to have any bit of consistency. And by consistency, I'm just being a loose when I say that. So that's it. Looks like this is going back to Ruger.